Well, we have a big show coming up a little later. We have a small business owner. Yeah. We also have an author. People like small business. If you've never heard the show before, you must be wondering, what the fuck is going on right now? Anyway.
Hey, Scott. Hey, what's up, man? How you doing, man?
Hey, Shimmy?
Yeah, it's me.
Shimmy, come on out here. Shimmy, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow. Man, this is exciting.
Shimmy.
I've never been in front of this many people before. Are you as excited as I am?
I am. It's hard to contain myself.
Wow.
Shimmy, you were in my backyard for a while.
That's right. I got lost there. I remember I was trying to find my way out.
And you somehow found your way inside the Earwolf studio.
Right.
And now you're here in the Ace Hotel Theater?
If you say so. What's up, y'all? Shout out to the two balconies.
No.
Is that bad?
No, we don't shout them out.
Oh, man, I'm sorry. I gotta retract my shout out, y'all.
Shimmy, this is so great that you're here because I've always wanted to talk to you at length.
Sure, man.
And at width.
You. How about at density? Let's have a dense conversation.
Sure.
You can ask me anything, man. Shimmy's open book.
I would love to know more about you because I got to know you. You were playing with Townland, the band.
Yeah.
Right? What instrument were you playing?
I played the spoons.
How does one take an interest in playing the spoons?
Well, my older brother was a chef. Mm. And I saw how much fun he was having with all those implements. And I was like, I gotta get on that. But I always had a musical bent, too.
Really? You've always enjoyed music?
I've always enjoyed music.
Listening to it, humming along to it.
Man, that covers it all. If I wasn't listening to it, I was definitely humming along to it, and vice versa.
Hard to hum along to it if you're not listening to it at the same time.
Yeah, then you're just humming.
Hoping you're humming along to it.
Man, sometimes I'd hum a song, and I'll think, I hope this is matching up with the song playing somewhere. Maybe somewhere on the other side of the world, in North Korea or something.
I don't know how many songs they're playing.
Oh, man, there's got to be so many songs in North Korea. Because I would hum songs like, I love you, Kim Jong-un. I think you are so cool.
The goon?
I think you are so cool.
So cool. Oh, okay.
But lagoon's a good rhyme for something.
Oon.
Oon. Kim Jong-un in a lagoon. It must be June. Get there soon. And then it just gets higher and higher.
How high do you think you could go if you had to?
I think that was it. I topped out.
Okay. And you, why did you choose the spoons? Because your brother, it seems, was using knives, primarily forks.
And I saw those spoons just sitting there lonely like in Beauty and the Beast when the spoon was alive and had feelings.
Is that one of your favorite movies, Beauty and the Beast?
Yeah. I was like, I saw that living spoon, and I was like, I'd like to smash that against another spoon. Show him what's what.
Another living spoon.
Yeah. Human dominion over spoons. That was kind of my raison d'etre for a while. If I may, pardon my French.
I didn't know you spoke French, Jimmy.
I don't. That's the only phrase I know.
Really?
I also know si vous plaît.
Okay. What about oui?
Oh, for yes.
Yes.
That's clever.
It's not just for wee. anymore.
How come no is the same everywhere, but then everybody's got a different yes?
Is that why we can't all get along?
I'm a bit of a seeker.
So, Shimmy, you grew up loving music. You bashed a couple of spoons together and made some sort of a percussionary noise.
It's a clickety-clack that everyone loves.
Yeah, clickety-clack, that train going back.
Hey, that's a song.
It is a song. You ever play the spoons to that song?
To Blues of the Night?
Yeah.
Nope.
I think any song that has the words clickety-clack in it is just begging for
spoon. I know, but it's so slow. It's like they was trying to confound spoon players. Does anyone know this song?
We could sing it.
We could try.
Here we go. A hooey, a hoo.
You're just going to start in the middle?
Yeah. Wait, you want to start at the beginning and do the whole thing?
Why not? It kills time.
I don't know that we're looking to kill time tonight.
Do you remember there's an old cartoon with a buzzard who was like, my mama done told me?
I remember the buzzards in, was it the Jungle Book?
Hey, is that supposed to be happening?
I don't know. What is that?
Oh, man. We're at church now. Hey, y'all, I want you to look inside yourselves and ask, am I good? Am I worthy? Wait. Oh, I think I know what's happening. I think a cue got jumped.
Where is she?
Guess that's it for Shimmy.
Where is she?
Oh, wow. Man, this cape figure just came in. He kicked a couple stools. He stepped very carefully over a monitor. Now he's settling himself on the
stool. Settling in, readjusting his t-shirt and his Wolverine mask.
Where is she?
Who?
Ladies and gentlemen, Batman is here.
Wait, the Batman?
The Batman, yes.
Not the Batman.
I'm the Batman.
You're in the bathroom?
I'm the Batman.
You're in the bathroom?
I'm in the bathroom. Currently. Hello.
Hi, Batman.
It's good to see you, Paul. Scott.
Nice to see you. I'm Shimmy.
He's Shimmy. He's... Do wind sprints. Sorry. Do wind sprints. That's your punishment.
There he goes. Oh, no.
No. Pick that back up, Batman. You can't just come in here knocking
on,
down stools and calling people wrong names.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Sit down, Batman.
Come on, Batman.
I'm in the bathroom.
Hey, behave yourself, Batman. Come on. Settle down now. Simmer down. Remember that?
Yeah, simmer down.
Simmer
now.
Down now.
Yeah.
Saturday Night Live.
That's right.
Cheeseburger.
You know, Batman, I would think you'd be out fighting crime Saturday nights at 11:30.
No, there's no crime in Los Angeles on a Saturday night at 9:30.
That's true. Town.
Not on my watch.
Oh. Because the show, it goes on because it's Saturday at 11:30, not because it's ready. Is that
we
right?
Don't fight crime because we're ready. We fight crime because it's 11:30. Commissioner Gordon said that.
Did you say Commissioner Gordon?
He's the one who said that quote, yes.
Right.
Oh, well, Batman, you're all over the place this year.
Me?
You are, what?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yes, you.
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 You, Batman.
You are having a moment, Batman.
Stop.
It's true.
It's true. You're in that long-ass, boring movie. And
oh, my teen angst film.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Something in the way. Fucking pussy.
I was terrified by that Riddler and his mind for wordplay, and they just beat the shit out of that one guy.
I was like, what a riddle. How's he going to solve this one?
That's not my Batman. You're my Batman.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah. How'd you feel when that came out?
A lot of things, really.
Sure.
You know, it brings up a lot. It makes,
Uh-oh, he's going Dracula mode.
It reminds me of when they killed my parents.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's crying behind this cape.
When I say they, I mean Tony Shalhoub, as we know. Tony Shalhoub killed my parents.
Right. Man, Tony Shalhoub killed your parents.
Okay, I can't understand a word.
This is like Dr. Sweet Chat here, where we're going to have to translate everything you're saying.
I wish I could explain to you that I can only see your knees. Since the moment I...
Is this helpful, Batman?
I'm not going to lie. This is 1,000% better.
Hey, man. Hey, so like... Do you know what I think? Nope. Oh.
Well, by the way, Batman, we're getting a good view, too.
I went from Batman to Fat Man real quick.
Hey, Batman.
This is like, so much better.
Oh, good.
For me.
I feel like nobody... Because you're a creature of the night.
I am.
And it's too bright in here.
I live in the shadows and the darkness.
Right, right.
For I am vengeance.
That's right. You lie snug as a bug in a rug.
I'm not going to lie. I feel awesome right now.
Hey, you know what? Here's what I feel like nobody ever asked you. When the night your parents got killed and that strand of pearls fell on the ground... How was that movie? Was it good?
It was not enough to lose your parents over.
Okay.
Also, all I remember every time my parents are killed, all I remember is pearls flying in the air. No matter what happens, there's always pearls.
I feel like every movie review should say at the end, is it worth losing your parents over?
Have you ever seen a movie?
Is it worth losing your parents over? Home Alone.
Home Alone? Sure.
Is it worth losing your parents over? Space Jam, the new one. It might work.
I saw that movie, Mad Max Fury Road, and I was like, that's good. If I came out of this and my parents were dead, I'd be like, okay.
Look, my parents are dead, but you see those guys on those fucking poles swinging around? That was dope.
That was really cool.
Help off to the funeral.
I like laughed out loud when that happened. I was like, this movie's crazy.
Yeah. No, I never got to say I love you to my mom, but the guitar guy shot flames.
Wait. Even as a kid, you never said I love you to your mom?
I didn't get a chance.
You didn't get a chance.
You were like 8 years old,
like
Batman.
Your schedules didn't line up? Uh-oh, he's retreated.
It's hard for me to open up.
My neck is starting to hurt.
Yeah, let's get back
up. You can come back up. It's fine. I appreciate that. Take your...
Hey, Batman, we gave you a little bit of floor time. We gave you a little bit of tummy time so you could see us.
I think... I don't know what... All I heard... Summertime cash? What did you say?
Summertime cash.
Summertime cash.
And the living is easy. No credit accepted.
Batman, do you never want to take off your mask?
Well, me?
Yeah, you. Are you afraid we'll know your secret identity?
What do you mean, secret identity? I'm the Batman.
Don't have a secret identity.
Oh, come on, Batman.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Batman, come on.
Batman. You expect people to believe that you're like just the Batman, like you vote in municipal elections and what have
for,
you?
For the comptroller?
I do. I used to work at Best Buy.
As Batman.
Yes, my name tag
said... Oh, come on.
My name tag said Batman. I worked in the DVD section.
Batman, we know. What are you doing?
I'm just
getting
cozy.
It's like you're wearing a Snuggie. What is happening?
I'm just getting cozy. I don't wear shorts normally.
Batman, we know your secret.
Who, me?
Batman, everybody knows.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Yeah, you. Everybody knows Batman.
Where is she?
Who?
Vicky Vale.
Vicky Vale?
Vicky Vale?
Vicky Vale?
She's great, isn't she? I'd like to bust that body. Can you say that anymore? Am I allowed to say that?
Batman, we know who you are. It was in that movie, all your movies. I don't know why you let those movies out.
There's not a single one where we don't know who Batman is.
I can't. It's how I pay for all my glorious gadgets as I keep licensing my rights. I'm an idiot.
Wait, that's where you get all those toys?
That's where I get all those wonderful toys, yes. They know the film.
Batman, we're in trouble. This town needs an enema.
It truly does.
I'm not far behind.
Well, you live in this town.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping to be within the city limits when it happens.
Do you think they're ever going to do that, citywide enemas?
Because if it was like a local holiday, at least, like Enema Day.
And they were supposed to do it. They were supposed to do a citywide enema, but then everyone got wrapped up in that RICO Act.
The RICO Act. Yeah. I love that part of that movie. Where
the most important
lawyer
part
goes
of any Batman movie, the RICO Act. Ow.
What happened, Batman?
I think I just chipped a fucking tooth.
Oh, no. You're Batman, are you used to working with microphones.
Yeah.
I'm not used to working with these microphones.
Are you suddenly figuring out that this mask is not really feasible? Or
what mask?
Oh, come on, Batman.
Come on, Batman.
We all wear masks.
Batman, don't be shy.
You can't say what mask and we all wear masks. Come on. Come on, man. You trying to have your cake and eat it too,
my
Batman.
My real face is the mask.
What?
What?
My real
face. Your real face is the mask,
that's
right?
Under the mask.
Right, right, right.
The face that I show people every day.
Right.
That's
Bruce Wayne.
That's the real mask.
Is he just gone for good, or
I don't know.
What's going
yeah.
on?
Batman.
Oh, well, he made a bat noise. Now he's flapping around. Oh no, he's trapped in the house. Get a broom. We gotta get him out of here.
Where is she?
Who?
Maggie Gyllenhaal.
All right, Batman.
Or Katie Holmes.
Jeff. Batman, do you want to stick around for the whole show? Are you all right if Batman?
Sure, I mean, there's no fucking crime going on. Why not?
Okay, Batman, everyone.
Doing his signature wave to everybody. Hello, y'all.
Bat wave.
Na 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 na.
Bat wave.
That was a good theme song.
That was one of the best theme songs. You know, a better theme song though.
Safe life repair. Safe life replace. Hey, Batman.
Yes.
Did anybody ever?
Wait, who, me?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, you, Batman.
Did anybody ever steal a baby from you?
Yes.
And what did you say to that person?
Give me back my son.
Wait a minute.
That's from Ransom.
That's from Ransom. Starring the defrocked actor Mel Gibson.
I'm not Mel Gibson.
Okay.
Okay, we're glad.
That narrows it down.
We're actually glad about
that. Yeah. Oh, there he goes. He's gone again.
Oh, no. He might be Mel Gibson. He's so shy.
I'm not Mel Gibson.
Oh, say it like that.
Say sugar tits.
Say it.
Say it. Say it.
Say what?
Sugar tits.
Sugar tits.
Oh,
I think he's Mel definitely Mel Gibson.
Mel Gibson. Batman's secret identity
sugar
is Mel Gibson?
Tits. Big, big old Jewish sugar tits. I'm not Mel Gibson.
All right, Batman, you just stay right there. We have another guest.
Just stay right there, Batman.
Who, me?
Does that ever work? Has a criminal ever said that to you? Just stay right there, Batman.
It did once. O.J. Simpson.
What did he say?
O.J. O.J. Simpson.
Oh, right. Orenthal James Simpson.
Orenthal.
The defrocked football player.
It's a Naked Gun. Midas Touch. A Midas commercial. Not Midas Touch.
The Midas Touch?
He does a lot of stuff with the Midas Touch organization now. Excuse me. My voice got very real.
I heard he killed somebody. OJ killed somebody. I turned them to gold.
Wait, I'm not Pee Wee Herman.
He's either Mel Gibson or Pee Wee Herman.
Do you think jerking off in a movie theater is a crime, Batman?
I love jerking off in movie theaters.
Oh, now I'm really confused.
I guess that's a no.
All right, we have to get to our next guest.
Who, you?
It's not you.
Very hot.
All right. All right, he's the aforementioned small business owner. He runs the Bobblehead Museum. Please welcome Darren Matichek. Darren!
Bobblehead Bowie, Bobblehead Bowie. I got you.
You got Bobblehead Bowie.
I said
yes.
Bobblehead Bowie. I got you.
Yes, he got you.
I got him good.
He got
him
good.
This is Batman.
Hi, Batman.
Who is, where is she? And hello.
Uh-oh. I'm having trouble understanding what Batman said.
Yep. Hey, welcome to the club.
You know, I have a few Batmans in my Bobblehead Museum and Hall of Fame.
I'd love to see them one day.
He'd love to see them one day.
A Batman translator.
It's actually easier to hear behind him. Batman chipped his tooth on the microphone.
Another
again.
Tooth.
Man. Once bitten, once shy.
Boy, it's great to be here.
Thank you, Darren. Thank you for being here. This is also Shimmy, by the way. Shimmy is over
How's
there.
How's it going?
Hey, Darren. How you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good.
I think bobbleheads are fun.
Hey, thanks. Me too. The great thing about a bobblehead is you have a statue, but the head moves around.
Yeah.
And usually they're made in the shapes of, celebrities, athletes, people that you know, and you can even customize them. So I could make Scott, I could make your head on Batman's body. And it'd be like, Batman.
I'm good.
What's wrong with my body? I'm a superhero.
Clearly. No, I know. I think you look great.
No shade. No,
I get it.
No shimmy?
No shame, no shade.
No shade, no shame, no shimmy. Hey, let me ask you something, Darren. Is that something you do often? Is you take one head, you put it on a different body for a bobblehead?
Absolutely. A lot of bobbleheads are basically, made the same way. So you could pop the head off of one bobblehead and put it on the body of another bobblehead.
I don't know. That seems unethical.
Cheaters never prosper, Darren.
I'm not trying to prosper. I'm trying to live long. I think you know what I mean.
I see what you did there.
I thought the idea was to do both. I didn't know it was a choice.
Nope.
Live long or prosper.
You got to pick one. Live long or prosper. Live long or prosper.
Huh?
Boy, that would throw a wrench in those movies. Why don't they remake movies and just change one stupid thing like that?
Yeah. Like what? Like Jaws. What would they do?
Yeah, they changed Jaws, but they call the movie Mouth.
That's the only difference. Hey, when they rebooted Will and Grace, why didn't they rename it Will or Grace? Let the audience decide.
Will then Grace. Every time she leaves a room.
How about Will if Grace?
Will. Oh, now we're back to Will and Grace.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, we've circled back around.
I guess that's what they went through.
Let me punch that up. That's the first thing. I've been reading a lot of comedy biographies.
Oh, you have? Really? Of whom?
Oh, I can't remember. But one of the main things that comedy people like to do is, let me punch that up. If you say that in the comedy room, you're automatically like, well, this person must know what they're talking about. Because they want to punch it up. Do you know what I'm saying? Hey, I just got my first colonoscopy.
Hey, congrats.
Congratulations.
Or did you make a bobblehead out of that?
How?
I'm not suggesting that you made a plastic cast of your butthole. I'm saying...
I think you are.
Yeah, I mean, thank you, Batman. That's exactly what
that does exactly seem like the antithesis of a bobblehead.
So I'm saying a bobblehead of you, like, getting it with the body, getting it. Yeah. That's what a bobblehead does, Jimmy.
Could be you bent over and your prolapsed anus is the... Just a suggestion.
It's not bad. Hey, no bad ideas, right?
There's literally no bad ideas.
How much can you see?
Right now, I see a fist.
Okay. I'm just looking at your milky eyes.
I see a fist. I gotta say, though, I'm having a fucking fantastic time.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, Batman.
You deserve it, Batman, for all you do.
It's really good to see you guys.
It's good to see you too, man.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Darren, what are some of the newest bobbleheads that you have in the museum? We love hearing about the bobbleheads that you have. New additions.
New additions. So,
do you have any of new addition?
Yeah, we get new additions. Oh, the
Bobby,
band new
Ricky,
addition.
Bobby, Jerry,
Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, and Mike. And if I got your girl, who cares who you like?
Right.
Something like that.
Yeah, we have new addition at the pancake breakfast, and they're all patting their bellies and their heads are nodding. So it seems like it's a bobblehead about how much they like the pancake breakfast. But then again, most bobbleheads, they seem to be nodding yes.
That's right. Wait. It's hard to make them nod no.
Yeah, that's true. Very
Darren,
difficult.
Yeah. Are there any who ever were nodding no, shaking their heads back and forth?
I mean, when they were first starting to make bobbleheads, they used to only shake their heads no.
What?
And they didn't sell.
Too negative?
Too negative. People would be like, hey, there's, you know, and then they smack the head and then it shakes its head no. And people would get confused, you know?
Well, it's a subtle just sign to them of like, don't buy me, don't buy me.
Exactly. So they weren't flying off the shelves.
Yeah.
And then there was an accident at the factory.
No.
And they accidentally, a mechanism got screwed up and they started shaking their heads yes. And then
this is a happy accident.
Yeah, happy accident.
Wow. Incredible. Do you remember what bobblehead that was? Is that in the bobblehead lore?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. It was Bilbo Baggins. and it was right when someone was presenting the ring to him. And so he used to shake his head no, and they were like, this isn't selling at all. This bobblehead sucks.
He needs to take that ring.
Yeah, he loves it. He wants it.
Is that what happened in that movie? Someone presented him the ring? I thought he went and got it.
Huh?
Didn't he go get it?
No, that's the movies. In the books, someone presents it to him.
Oh, really? Yeah. He just asks for it?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm thinking in the books, it's like a guy from Joston shows up.
Or Herf Jones, one or the other. It's Joston's or Herf Jones.
Hmm.
Yeah, because in the books, they fight over who gets to make the ring that they ask Bilbo to take.
Yeah.
And Bilbo's like, I don't know.
Is he getting married or something? What is he?
Yeah, he's getting married to Samwise.
Samurais?
Samurais.
This is a very different book.
Yeah.
Sounds fucking dope.
It's like Rashomon.
Oh, wow.
Do you like film?
I love film.
This guy.
I would watch the shit out of that.
Have you ever done a Rashomon bobblehead where it's three different versions of the same bobblehead?
Absolutely. It gets really confusing. People start to question objective reality.
Hmm.
But some say that's useful, so, you know.
The doors of perception.
Those are the bobbleheads that we give away for free to trick people into learning a lesson. Because people don't want to pay for the truth. They want the fantasy.
I mean, that's the bobblehead game right there.
Yeah. So, Darren, it's bobblehead season, obviously.
Oh, it's always bobblehead season.
That's what I mean.
Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. Hey, I should use that. It's bobblehead season. Is it? Yes.
It's always. What's new on the horizon for bobbleheads? You always come on the show and you let us know what's trending for 2022 and beyond.
Bigger bobbleheads.
Bigger.
Life-size bobbleheads.
Life-size?
Whose life?
It's my life. It's now or never. I am going to live forever, but not prosper. So the new trend in bobbleheads is life-size bobbleheads that you can crawl into, and then when someone taps the head inside from the inside, you can say, please don't do that. And that freaks people out, like Impractical Joker style. That's a, oh, and it's filmed on a Ring camera.
Throwing shade at the way Impractical Jokers is filmed.
Yeah, they're getting
Impractical Joker because Murr is much smaller than Sal.
What? I say on behalf of the audience. Yeah.
I co-signed that one. I didn't catch any of that.
I said.
Wait, did you just say I said?
I said.
Hey, if you want to know what Batman said, scan the QR code.
Oh, Batman, come back, Batman.
Who, me?
Yes,
did you fucking
Batman.
Hear that? Did you fucking understand that shit? My fucking parents were killed.
I know. Hey, everybody's parents were killed. Why don't you use your daytime voice sometimes?
Fan.
Batman, I'm sure people ask you this all the time when they see you in the street. Do you have a softer side?
I used to.
Oh, that's too bad. Okay, moving on. You know, we've talked about having a softer side to bobbleheads.
Really?
Yeah.
Because usually they're so hard.
Yeah, they're made out of plastic or
yeah. Which is one of the harder things in the world.
Here we go.
Diamonds, a chair, bobbleheads.
Yeah, it's number three.
My armor is made of recycled bobbleheads.
It is.
This is all armor.
Oh, yeah. Eco-conscious.
I think I can see different pieces of different bobbleheads. There's Condoleezza Rice enjoying Jack in the Box.
This is someone from the cast of Firefly over here.
So
probably
good.
Probably Summer Glau.
It was. That's, you got it.
There's Alan Tudyk as the racist manager in 42. You have a lot of Firefly related things here.
Uh-oh, is that Castle I see? Castle on the knee.
So what is coming out in 2023, Darren?
Oh, now you want to know about 2023?
2023, look, 2022, it's almost over. We need to know what are the bobbleheads that are coming next.
Well, so what I was saying, I was alluding to with the softer side stuff, yeah, is that there's going to be plushy bobbleheads.
Plushies, really?
Yeah, plushy wow. bobbleheads. But we're still in the beta testing phase because so far the bodies have been soft, but the heads are still hard bobbles, so they just fall over. Mm. So there's really only one bobble from the head.
One and done.
One and done. A one pump chump, I suppose you could say.
Sure. I suppose.
You know, if you're only pumping once, are you really a chump? You probably have something medically wrong with you. And we should have sympathy for these people that are pumping and dumping once.
I didn't realize it was a one pump and dump chump.
If you pump and you don't dump, you are a chump.
It's just one pump. I'm not going to dump. But I'm going to exit the room.
Come on, you chump. You forgot to dump.
One yeah. pump, no dump, got to jump. I'm a chump.
Batman, anything?
Who, me?
Well, this is incredible, Darren. It's incredible to hear.
Hey, I got a question for yeah. Darren. What's like your biggest bobblehead time of year? Like, is it Christmas time? Is it 4th of July? Is it Valentine's Day?
Keep guessing.
That's all I got.
Like best boss day. I feel like a lot of bosses get...
Best boss day?
Man, they tried to get that going.
You're
it's National Boss Day.
National Boss Day. I just think it's a great idea. I think you're fucking wrong about that. I think it would be a great day.
Batman, you're self-employed. What do you care about Best Boss Day?
I'm a rich billionaire. Wait, what?
I heard it.
What is the best time of year, though? I mean, I would imagine...
It's definitely Valentine's Day because...
Really?
Yeah, what says love or I want to make love to you more than a bobblehead? A personalized bobblehead of your lover?
Cha-ching, you were going to say? is that the noise you make when you have sex?
Yeah, and then, well, see, that's what's sad. If you only pump once, then you'll hear one cha-ching. But, you know, if it's going for 5 to 7 minutes, that's a lot of cha-chings. Because each pump is a cha-ching. Cha-ching, 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 cha-cha-cha.
Does, like, a long receipt come out as well? CVS receipt?
Yeah. Hey, what's longer than the CVS receipt?
What's
My
longer
dick.
Than it?
My dick.
Batman, oh, come on.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Sit down,
now he's
sit
strutting
down,
around.
Batman. Oh, Batman. Oh, you're not here to do Batman. Street jokes, Batman.
Oh, shit. I'm curious. What is your rarest bobblehead?
Oh,
what
good question, Batman.
That's a great question.
Thank you.
Rarest bobblehead that I've ever seen. And again, people can lay claim to this, but most bobbleheads have been, there are at least two or three of them made. But there's one bobblehead that I've heard there's only one of them Ooh. In existence. It's Richard Nixon giving $20 to a Girl Scout for a box of cookies. And on the box of cookies, it says, "Fuck you, Richard Nixon." He didn't know he was buying something that was meant to embarrass him.
Wow.
And they made one of them, and he shut it down.
He shut it down personally?
He shut down the operation.
So he was excited to see this bobblehead made of him. He was there at the assembly line.
Yeah, it was all PR. He was like, this is great. But the person on the assembly line hated Richard Nixon and cooked in a fuck you, Richard Nixon. And he got wind of it, and he shut the whole operation down.
Wow. And where is this bobblehead now? Where does it reside?
It's in my safe at home.
If anyone ever steals it, let me know.
Are you gonna go after it for me?
Or you want to buy it from the thief?
No, I'm just... If it gets stolen, I could help because I'm a crime fighter.
What?
That's all I...
Sorry.
Don't look at me, Batman.
We each get to say what, at least.
I was doing something nice. I was saying, if someone steals it, give me a call. You got a direct line to Batman. Jesus fucking Christ, guys. Just trying to do something nice. I was saying, if somebody steals your bobblehead, I'll come.
This is like the Rockford Files or something?
If you want my cell phone number to be friends, you can just ask for it.
All right, do you want to hang out? That's all I'm saying. I have a cave and a Batmobile and a giant penny.
What was that giant penny supposed to go into?
Was it? I'm sorry, what?
He got you good.
Oh, he got you.
Batted at my own bat. What was it supposed to go into? Like a giant slot machine? Or like
yeah,
a...
Yeah, no,
okay, Batman. Great to talk to you.
Can I ask Darren one more question?
Yes, please.
There's an episode of The Twilight Zone starring Captain Kirk where he's sitting at a diner and then there's like a little devil bobblehead. And they ask it some questions, and then the answers are bad. Are there any cursed bobbleheads?
Absolutely.
What? Absolutely?
The most cursed bobblehead is the Pete Rose bobblehead that is not in the Hall of Fame and is only in the museum. And rumor has it, why do you seem skeptical?
Because you don't want it in the Hall of Fame because Pete Rose is not going into the Hall of Fame. Is
yeah,
that
correct.
Right? Oh, okay.
Yes.
But it is in the museum.
Yeah, but great. People say it's cursed. Everyone who touches it befalls a tragic fate.
No, like what?
They gamble on themselves and lose.
Wow.
And you always want to be able to bet on yourself.
Yeah.
You told me that the first time I met you.
It was after the show.
Oh, it was?
That's nice, though, Scott.
Hey, no, it was. It sounded mean. It sounded like a slight. He was like, hey, you might want to bet on yourself. I was like, what?
I take it back, then.
How does that sound mean to say?
It did sound mean the way he presented it.
Well, I mean, it was your tone of voice, the way you said it.
You might want to bet on yourself. That doesn't sound good.
But it's really hard for me to sound mean because of my accent.
Yeah, you have that, what is it, Wisconsin? Is that where you're from?
Yeah, I'm from Milwaukee.
Milwaukee.
Yeah. Ever been?
As I remember, yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh. All right, well, I'll text you about it later.
I feel like we're in a weird headspace
right
now. What happened? I don't want to hang out with you, if that's what you're asking.
Oh, cool, okay. Well, me and Batman will be in Milwaukee.
If anyone wants to hang out, I'm just blanket. I love hanging out.
When do you have time, Batman?
The daytime.
You sleep during the day.
Uh-oh.
Batman's retreating. I'm sorry, Batman. I'm sorry. I don't mean to. I don't want to hurt your feelings,
Something
Batman.
Something in the
He's singing Nirvana.
Why?
Because of that new movie. They.
I'm so fucking sad. I'm so sad.
It's sad, but it's emo Batman. He's
so sad.
Morphed into emo Batman.
Baby, got my
daddy here from the rose on a hill.
Did a little Pearl Jam sneak in there?
Baby!
Kiss from a Rose, Pearl Jam.
They should have covered it. If they had any guts. Pearl Jam.
But they're all cowards.
Coward. I call you out, Pearl Jam. Cover Kiss by a Rose or GTFO.
I love singing Pearl Jam at karaoke.
Why is that, Darren?
Because it's funny when I sing it.
Do you want to sing some of it right now? How do you sing it?
Okay, let's pick a Pearl Jam song.
Okay, you want Jeremy or Even Flow? What,
yeah, Even Flow.
Even Flow, okay.
Even Flow. Oh, no, that was all the only words of that song that I know.
How about Jeremy Spoken?
He hit me with a surprise left. My jaw left hurting.
What's that one where he goes, he's a little fuck?
Jeremy alive.
Little fuck.
Yellow Ledbetter.
In Jeremy, it's one of the lyrics.
Oh yeah, where he's like, yeah, hit me with a surprise left. Little fuck. Now I'm in the weird headspace. You just wanted to hear me say little fuck. Little fuck. Thanks for the one pump, little fuck. No dump. You need
little
to take.
Fuck. Little fuck.
Where you put the little fuck into my house? Blah, blah. All right, Darren Matichek, everyone.
Thank you. Yeah. I'll see you later.
No, stay here.
Oh, okay. I'll move over there.
No, I'll move over there.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry I didn't move. I can't see very well.
I sit here?
No, Batman. It's okay. You've done enough. All you've done for everybody in Gotham, other places?
Mostly Gotham.
Yeah.
Sometimes you go to Metropolis and hang out with Superman.
True, true.
And then you guys smash up some buildings. Do you ever feel bad about that?
Every day.
Oh, Batman. Look, Batman, we have another guest coming out. Are you excited by that?
Do you like that, Batman?
Yay.
We have an author coming out. Do you ever read a book, Batman?
I like books.
What's your favorite book, Batman?
Currently?
Or of all time?
The Bible.
Wow.
Guess there's a lot of laws in that.
They get broken.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's germane to your interests. Well, we have an author here. Never been on the show before. This is very exciting. Please welcome Anaheim Dumpsterbitch. Anaheim Dumpsterbitch.
Hello. Hello, Dick from Quentin. I am good. Hello. I am Anaheim Dumpsterbitch. And I am from the European Union. Woo! European Union, I believe in the unification of Europe. Woo! For social, cultural, and economic implications.
feel like you and Batman, we're going to have to...
Who, me?
Yes, you. And
you're really going to have to bridge the gap between us.
Bridge the gap between us, yes.
I'm catching most of it.
Oh, you are? Good.
If I'm honest.
I'm going to be honest, not a single thing over here. But is I... It?
Yes.
Fast friends, I'll tell you.
Yes, this is Batman. Have you ever met Batman before, Anaheim?
No, I have not met Batman. I have met Bat, but never Batman. Hello.
Never combined. Never a Bat and a man together.
What?
Don't worry. It takes a minute or two, and then you click into the cadence. And then you're okay. And don't make Batman feel bad about it. He's doing his best.
Me?
So, Anaheim.
I'm in the bathroom.
He's in the bathroom.
What?
He's in the bathroom.
I'm in the bathroom.
He's going to the bathroom.
On the stage.
He's going to the bathroom.
Ooh, it helps. He's going to the bathroom.
He's going to the bathroom.
Okay, Anaheim, you say something now.
I am from the European Union.
I'm from the European Union.
We got it.
All right.
All right, wonderful.
We're just too far away from the sound source.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, so we need to move up.
All right, Batman, you talk.
Hi, I'm in the bathroom.
That's what it was.
Wow.
Is that better?
Crystal clear.
Can you hear me now?
Crystal clear.
Can you hear me now? What's up, motherfuckers?
That made a big difference.
What's up, everybody? I'm Batman, bitches.
That's perfect.
Perfect. Wow.
Where the fuck have you guys been? Let's hear some fucking noise.
It's as simple as that. Wow.
It's just that simple.
Wow. You'll have to excuse me. I have COVID-19. Oh.
I love that Batman talking like that makes him cough, but not the other way.
Anaheim, so you're an author. We've never met before. You're an author from the European Union.
Yes.
What have you written? What are your books? What's your bibliography?
So, as you can see, I gave everybody a little peck when I came in here. And inside your peck, you're going to find a book. And in the book, it is all about red flags.
Red flags?
Red flag for a relationship. Oh. Ooh. So when you're in a relationship with somebody and it is just starting out, sometime you will see a red flag and that mean you have to say, oh, stop. No. I will not go down that path. No.
That's, you know, if you see a red flag when you're on the water, it usually means do not proceed.
Oh, I think this is different.
Oh, okay.
But, so, I can tell you about the book, but you guys should read it. Obviously, I gave you all a pack.
I got my pack.
You got your pack?
So, do you want us to read it right now? Do you want us to take a break?
No, I can tell you about it.
Oh, okay.
Oh, unless you need to take a break.
Should we take an hour break while we read this book? People want to stick around.
I think everybody
for
has
hour.
The patience for that.
Yeah, sure.
That would be dynamic.
A real power move. And then they took an hour break while they read a book on stage.
Well, for the listener, it'll be like no time has passed.
Right. So tell us about the book. I'd love to hear about it.
Okay, the first red flag for being in a relationship with somebody is if the person does drugs. Drugs are bad because people spend so much money on them.
The cost is what's wrong with them?
People spend so much money on acid, cocaine, LSD.
NIC? NTC?
ACDC.
ACACAB?
ACDC. LMNOP. When a person spends too much money on drug, they don't spend money on you.
Okay, yeah. Well, I mean, that can happen. Someone's life is just spiraling out of control because they're spending too much money on the drugs. They find that's all they want to spend money on. That is a great warning sign.
Right. Yeah. So, when they spend money on drug, they take time away from taking you out to fancy dinner, taking you to get your hairs removed, spending time with your horse. Basic things like that. That is why nobody wants to date somebody who do drunk, okay?
Okay, great. Great tip. Great
okay,
tip.
Next tip. Not
so
tip.
These are
no,
tips.
No, no, they're not tips.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no, no.
You remind
but
me of...
But they are similar.
Yeah. Similar voices, too.
It keeps slipping. It was a better backstage. where was I? Okay,
you
guys
phrase?
Ready for...
Do you have a phrase that can get you back into it?
Red flag?
Red flag, okay, good.
European Union!
There we go.
Okay, there we go.
European Union, okay. So...
So what's the next
second
red flag?
Red flag is if somebody... I don't know... is a risk taker.
That seems like it wouldn't be a bad thing. A lot of times these risks pay off and
yes,
with big dividends.
But when somebody is a risk taker, they could die falling out of a helicopter, rolling down a tree. These are big things. And when that happened, that take away from time they could be spending money on you and your horse.
If they're dead, yes, that takes a lot of time away from how much time they can spend on you.
Yeah,
with your horse.
Planning a birthday party for your horse. Simple thing like that.
Anaheim, what else is in the pack here?
In the pack, you have a European Union lanyard. You have a cardboard cutout of a big croissant.
Is the cardboard cutout big or just the croissant is big and it's a cardboard cutout?
Take a look.
Oh my God. Both.
It's very big. Oh, you took your
you
phone.
Tried to steal that. You're recording this.
This is like rerun when he's at the Doobie Brothers concert.
Which doobie you be? That's what he said.
That's right. I'd be Roger
caught.
Thomas. Which
they
doobie
said,
you?
Which doobie you be
which
when
doobie
he got
you
cut?
Be. Yeah. That's right. Classic TV.
What's happening?
We're singing the what's happening. Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah, I was. I've sung that at karaoke before.
I am from a different generation.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's true.
So, for other thing you find in your bag.
Yeah.
You find a matching vest.
Oh, wow.
Matching to what?
Matching.
It does match.
It matches itself.
Both sides match.
Another red flag I want to say. Do you never date nobody who play a video game?
Any video game.
Any video game.
From Pac-Man to Red Dead Redemption.
World War II Warcraft. World War I Warcraft. World War Vietnam Warcraft.
What about Animal Crossing? That seems okay.
No. All video games are bad because it takes time away from you spending time with your special somebody. Because when you spend time apart, they can't do fun thing with you, like go to movie theater complex and buy a big popcorn. Run along the Silver Lake Reservoir. Spending time with you and your horsey at your birthday party with all the presents for your horse.
Do you have a horse?
Well, how do you know I have a horse? I do have a horse.
What's your horse's name?
Mudderfugger. He is such a big horse. I wish he could be here today, but he can't. The building said no.
I'm so glad he's not here. That would have been terrifying.
For you?
If a horse was on stage,
Batman, you're scared of a horse?
I would fly away immediately.
What I mean, what if it happens if Gotham has a supervillain called the horse?
I'm fucking out. Call Superman, bud.
Why is it so scary to you?
A horse? It's muscles with a head.
But his legs are so spindly, like if a horse breaks his leg, he's done forever.
You ever see a bat fight a horse?
Oh man, I want to now.
I have video.
That should be the next movie, just Batman fighting a horse. For 3 hours. A big motherfucker, too.
Yeah.
It's Ezra Miller riding a horse.
What if a horse got in the Speed Force?
Oh, the Speed Horse?
Speed Force horse!
Oh, no.
2 minutes later!
I almost slid off my chair.
What happened?
I almost slid off my chair because of my cape.
Oh, Batman. Oh, Batman. Oh, no. This is a new low. Anyway, Anaheim, how big is your horse? A big
He's
horse?
He's a big
size?
Motherfucker. He's so big.
Does he like oats?
Oats?
Yeah.
Or does he like Garfunkel?
Yeah, Garfunkel. He like him. Yeah, no, he's a very big horse. I wish he could be here to die, but he can't. But if you look in your pack, you will find a big horse cock.
A big what? Horse cock?
I beg your pardon? I beg your pardon, Miss Dumpster Bitch?
You're not finished with that sentence, are you?
No, there it is.
Make sure you dig down deep. Take a look.
There it is. It's a huge horse cock. It's jiggling like a bobblehead.
It is a big horse cock that I found for all of you.
You found these? You found 5 horse cocks.
Batman is shocked.
Batman is scandalized.
Oh, Batman's never heard the like. Oh, man. Well, thank you for the horse cock. I don't want this, though. Do you mind taking
I'll
it home
take
with
it.
You?
I cannot take it home. No, I cannot go through customs with that again.
Right.
Why, I'll what? Take it. I got a cave full of weird shit.
How did you get it through customs to get it here?
I put it inside of my rolly luggage and I brought it on the plane. Nobody looks in your rolly luggage that you bring on the plane. Only when it goes into the plane underneath.
So that conveyor belt, they don't ever look at anything that goes through
there. No, that is the trick. You're welcome.
I'm the guy who doesn't want the horse cock.
I've got the question. Did Australia recently join the European Union?
It is very late at night, and sometimes people's voices change from when they first thought of whatever they were going to do at 3 p.m. Now they're struggling to get back to it.
Get back to
they're
it.
They're really struggling.
To get back to it.
Anyway, this is Australian, so very it's different. Actually a lot different than.
All right, that's our show, everyone. Lily Sullivan, Timbo.
love you.
Thank you.